studio apartment in Knoxville. I'm a student at UTK. I have been for a little while, and I recently decided to move off campus into an apartment, and this is the tour of that apartment. So stick around if you would like to see it. So we're gonna start with the bathroom. Let's do that. So this is my bathroom. I'll do a cut here to some close-up shots, but I have my toilet, obviously, my sink, my shower. On this side of the door is some storage that I have, and then on the back of the door, I have my robes hung up. Also over here, I have my towel rack and my scale, and I keep my trash can, and there's also another towel rack here where I keep my face towels. So yeah. We'll take you to the closets. So these are my closets. And this closet is a bunch of built-in drawers. So I keep all of my clothing that I fold in here. And this is more my utility closet. So in here I keep like my dirty laundry basket, my vacuum, my mop, some detergent and my ironing board, and also some like winter scarves and hats. And now I will show you the built-in section. So over here I have this lovely built-in. So you'll see in this building there's lots of built-ins because it's a pre-war building, but in this area with this built-in I keep my key wool, I hang my purse here when I come in, and I have this cute little Morton Salt girl steel hanging artwork. So yeah. So we just came out of the entryway, and over here is the bedroom area. So here I have a full-size bed with a little bench in front, my two side tables, which I got from TJmaxx Homegoods. The bed I've had for a while, but I'll link as much of the bedding as I can below. These two lamps I actually thrifted, so I'll be able to link those. But the lampshades are from Target. Over here we have this lovely built-in, another one of the built-ins that is with the building. I keep over here a bunch of my grandfather's art. You'll see on the other walls of my house my grandmother's art, and look forward to that. So here I just have a few old cameras. My great-grandfather was a photographer. A lot of these cameras don't work anymore, but they're really lovely to look at, so I brought them here. Got two candles, oil diffuser, and as well as an old conch shell that I've had for a long time. Over here we have my bookcase. My bookcase I've just recently got from Wayfair. I'll link it down below. I've just got a lot of knickknacks and decorative items that I've collected over the years, and these are mostly on this section, like school supplies. Down here I have my camera bag, some magazines, that stack will probably get thicker as the year goes on, just a few of my favorite books that I brought from home, and yeah, just some lovely mementos that remind me of the people that I love in my life and home, of course. So next we're gonna move on to the sitting area. Let's take you into the main area. So this is my beautiful sitting area. We'll start from this angle. This is my guitar and my amp. I keep them over here because they're still on display, but they're not in the way. And yeah, the light's really lovely right now, so let's give you a more direct view of the rest of the sitting area. So this is my favorite part of the apartment, probably just from how nice it is. This took me like months and months of searching online to get all of these pieces, and even then I had to DIY a few things. So the three pieces of art that you see above me are from my grandparents. They are my favorite items that I own. They mean quite a lot to me, and they all have their own special meaning, which I'll keep for myself, but they are also very beautiful as well as very sentimental. This couch that I'm sitting on right now is from Wayfair, as well as the chairs and the coffee table. So the chairs I actually DIY'd. So these used to be, you know, a normal wood color, but the wood color didn't really match with the darker walnuts that I had kind of throughout the space. So I decided to paint it just a fun color, and I picked baby pink. But it was a really fun project I got to do with my mom before I left for school again. This coffee table is just a Lucite coffee table. I've got some old Andy Warhol books on my coffee table that were from my grandparents that are also artists that you see. Just some fun, fresh hydrangea flowers. And this is actually my favorite candle ever, so I will definitely link that below because it is amazing. It smells awesome and it's really good at filling a space with its beautiful, beautiful smell. But yes, this is the sitting area, and then next I'll pan over to the entertainment, aka you'll see my TV, and then also my dinner table slash desk, which is also a lovely space that I spend a lot of time in. So this is my lovely kitchen table slash desk area. You'll see why I like to sit here in a little bit when I show you the view, because from this angle I can directly see the river, the Tennessee River. It was a big plus to buying this apartment. You know, the apartment's a little old and you might see that the walls have a few like cracks behind the paint, but really the beautiful hardwoods and the beautiful windows and the amazing view are what sold me on wanting to live here, even though it's a little bit older. If anything, I think it being older is just more memories that you know have happened here makes it really special. I've had this carpet for a long time, but if I can find it, I'll link it below, as well as the chair. This is a blanket I got for Christmas. It's kind of a tradition my family has every year. My brother and I always got new blankets. But this is actually an old table that my family had that I sanded down and restained, and then I also painted the bottom because it was kind of rusted and everything like that. But I really like the way it looks now. These candlesticks and the candle bases are both thrifted. This tray is from Homegoods, and this pot I actually made myself, which you'll understand when I get to a different part of this apartment. But yeah, those are just some dried flowers that I have, and all of my lovely plants. This is Marlin. But yeah, that's the kitchen table desk area, so this is where I'll be doing most of my schoolwork, as classes this semester are mostly online. It's gonna be a weird semester. To the side, we have my console table with my TV. I don't watch TV too often, but it's something that my friends and I like to do. It brings us together, watching movies, hanging out. So it's a necessity for me to have one. And below it, you'll see actually my air filter, which I turned off for this video, but usually it's on high to keep dust and things at a minimum. And yes. But yeah, that concludes the main area of the apartment. Next, we're gonna move on to my surprise, which is my pottery studio in my apartment. So let's go. So this is the beginning of the rest of my apartment, and it's my pottery studio. I've been doing pottery for under a year, but it's really, really calming for me, and it's something I really enjoy. One of the stressful parts of moving here was actually packing a lot of these things up. While most of it's bisqueware, which means it's been hardened, a lot of the pieces were not. And as you can see, some sad things happened while we were moving, but most everything except for this made it, so that's really cool. But over here you have my wheel. You might notice that there's something on the floor. We had to cover the walls and some of the floor in this room to protect it from all the clay that's gonna get everywhere. Because red clay, which is just clay right here, it stains. So we had to make sure that I would receive my security deposit back. Hopefully that will help. But yeah, this is just half of that. So, and then over to this side, I think I'll insert a clip here. We have just a really not very pretty storage bin with all of my clay and my glazes and my tools and my bats and everything like that that you need to make pottery. But I haven't fully moved in this part of the space, but it's going to become real loved on and moved in pretty quick once I start throwing, because things get messy really fast. But let's move on to the last part of the apartment, the kitchen. So I lost the main footage, but here's the B-roll. As you can see, the whole kitchen is white. It's actually original metal cabinets. It's got lots of storage, which is really wonderful. And I also brought along this metal table for extra counter space, but even though it's small, I really love it.
Well, thank you so much for watching. That was my Knoxville studio apartment tour. I hope you enjoyed. If you'd like to see more things from me, feel free to subscribe. I don't really have a schedule for posting videos, but I'll do them as much as I can. But thank you once again so much for watching. Bye!
Take me away into the night, out of the hum of the street lights and into a forest.